So we get asked a lot of the times on the phone of what is this exterior part on my house? What's rotting? Where's it all coming from? How does it rot? All of those questions. So today is just kind of a brief overview of what all those different parts are on a house. First and foremost, I mean, the obvious one, there's the gutter that's right here in front of me. Right below that, you're gonna have what's called either a fascia board or a gutter board, which is gonna be this component here. Underneath that, you're gonna end up having what's called a soffit, which is underneath it. It's also called an eave. Soffit's actually a material. Eave is technically gonna be the term that's used for the framing component, the actual overhang that comes out from the side of your house. If you actually follow that eave back, you're gonna see that you have this piece of metal actually here that's above the window. That's actually a lintel is what's put in there. Sometimes they're gonna be metal where you'll see them. Sometimes they're gonna be stone, sometimes brick, even sometimes they're gonna be wood. Above the ladder here, what you're gonna be seeing, that's gonna be a gable that shoots all the way up. Behind this metal trim is actually gonna be a rake board of what's there. Back underneath the eave, what you would end up having, let's say that against the brick, there was a board that would have been there. That would be considered what's called a freeze board, would be down underneath of that. And then all the way down here on the end of the eave, we have what would be considered a bird box is most of the time what that's gonna be called. On a home like this, traditional 1950s Cape Cod, what you're gonna be getting most of the time is rain's obviously gonna hit the roof. We can't stop that, no one ever can. It's gonna roll down, it's gonna get into the gutter. Typically where you're gonna see the issue is actually more than likely gonna be in between the gutter right here in the gap and then this gutter board or fascia board. Main reason why I say that is usually it's either a backup that happens in the gutter because the downspout is clogged, or you're gonna have it in the winter when you're gonna have some form of ice damming. That ice is gonna freeze in there, it's gonna get up underneath the shingle or underneath your tar paper. It's either gonna rot out the gutter board, or it's going to rot out your sheathing that's on your roof, or primarily the two zones that it's gonna rot in. There is one other spot up here that we can take a look at as well. That's gonna be this component that's up here where the gutter board ends up coming down, which is probably why this has been wrapped in aluminum in the first place, is right where the, sorry, not gutter board, where the gable board comes down here and meets the shingle. That's your second primary spot where you're probably gonna end up having wood rot at. All the water's just gonna collect and pool in this area. You're also gonna get some snow that's gonna be up in this area right on top of the roof here. When that ends up happening, typically that's where this board would end up rotting out just because it touches the shingle. Shingle's made of asphalt nowadays. Obviously that can't soak up water, but what can is the wood that's touching your roof. So it ends up soaking it up like a sponge, which is primarily how it ends up rotting out that board as well. So those are kind of the primary areas of rot, and those are the areas of the exterior of a house where, you know, there's a lot of nomenclature out there of what each one is called, and we're just trying to help sort out what's what here.